Hello, this is Sandra Kelly, and I wanted to introduce myself so that you can have a better understanding of how I came to get this information that I'm going to share with you in the next part of the course. First of all, I started my career getting my bachelor's degree in social work, so I decided to go work with victims and spent 4 years working with teenage and child victims of crime, which helped me to understand from their perspective what they experienced, what their perceptions of the people that committed crimes to them was, and how those criminals gained access to them. And this was an important factor. From there, I decided that I wanted to, that I was ready to work with the juvenile criminals that were incarcerated in the state of California. So I became a youth correctional counselor. This entailed supervising and counseling the juvenile criminals in an institutional prison setting. I worked with a psychologist to do intensive counseling with them. Individual, group therapy, training, teaching classes on victim empathy, how to prevent relapsing, and the particular unit that I spent most of my time on, I spent at least 10 years in, was a sex offender unit. And working intensively with these sex offenders, I gained a lot of insight into how they think, how they feel, how they behave, how they selected their victims, how they gained access to their victims. And some of them, a few, were actually psychopathic and were never going to have any empathy for anybody. A lot of them had become sociopathic and learned how to manipulate people to gain their trust so they could have access to them. And there were, you know, an array of other crimes that these juveniles had committed. They were from the ages of 15 to 22, so they weren't all so young. From there, I decided that it was important for me to go out into the community. And in order to do so, I went to the Parole Agent Academy to do more of the law enforcement work, because I had the capacity to arrest them if I had to. But I also was responsible for referring them to counseling, training, jobs, having to get to know their family, friends, where they worked, and having to know where they hung out and what they did. Having to deal with gangs and sex offenders in the community that were released from prison. Even people that had been in prison for 35 years for committing murder. So I had a large array in the next 10 years of doing that, working, you know, with various types of criminals. So I gained a lot of insight into how a lot of them were able to change, some of them were able to change, and then how some of them chose not to change, and how their thought processes and how they viewed people and victims that made it okay for them to victimize people. And there are people that it just, crime is just a way of life, and every day they're looking for that opportunity. And the important message that I want to share in this next training is to empower you with the knowledge of how they think, feel, behave, and how they're picking their victims and trying to gain access, how they're trying to gain your trust. So I want you to become empowered and to be able to travel safely and confidently with the knowledge that you're not going to be a victim, and you're not going to allow them to gain access to you.